Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about a feature which became generally available in Summer 24 release. After this Summer 24 release, you have the option to use the reactive component inside your screen flow to collect user information and then use that information to create related records inside your Salesforce flow. This is a very powerful feature. So without wasting any time, let's see this feature in action. Okay, so here I am in my Summer 24 release org. The first thing that I'll do, I'll go to the setup, and from setup, I will type flow and I'll go to the flow section. Inside flow section, I click on new flow, and this is a place where I'll start building my new flow from scratch, and it will be a screen flow. So I'll select screen flow and click on continue. Here, I will start with an element which is basically get records. I'll give it a name, get all accounts. My intention is to select all the active accounts from my Salesforce org. So in the object, I'll select account. Here I will put the condition as active equals yes. And very important, I will select all the records, not the first record. So with all the accounts selected, I will start with my screen element. So I'll select the screen element. The first thing I'll put on the screen element is basically the data table. So I'll search for data table and bring the data table in the screen element. I'll give it a name as all accounts. The level of the data table is all accounts. Here in the source collection, I'll select accounts from get all accounts or the previous element. In the configure row, I'll make it a single row selection. In the configure columns, I will first choose account number, followed by one more column, which is basically, I'll select, let's say, account name, and click on done. Now, what I will do is basically, I'll search for the element repeater and bring that in the screen element. Here, I'll give a name of this repeater, like repeater 1. Now, inside repeater, I'll first put text. I need to put this inside repeater. This is basically the first name of my contact. I'll make this as required. Then I will put another text, which is going to capture the last name of the contact. Then I'm going to capture the email address. So I'll give it a name as email. And then a checkbox, which is basically, the intention of the checkbox is basically, okay, this is an email. And yeah, that's correct. So I'll put the checkbox, the next one. And the intention of the checkbox is I'll ask the user whether they want to share the date of birth of the contact. So want to share your date of birth? That's a question and it's a checkbox. And then under that, I will put date and I will give the label as date of birth. So what I want basically, date of birth, this section should only be visible when someone check the checkbox, want to share your date of birth. So I'll put this checkbox value equals to true. That's the time only when this date of birth section will be visible to the screen of the flow, right? So let's click on done. So now my screen is ready. What I'm going to do, I'm going to create a loop element now to go through all the information that I've captured. So basically loop, let's give a name as loop through contacts. Collection is basically the, I think what I need to do, this repeater and then all items. Perfect. Then the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to assign the information to a single contact record. So create single contact. For that, I need to create a variable of contact record. So let's give it name as single contact. Data type will be record and object will be contact. I'll not choose allow multiple values. Everything looks good. Click on done. So single contact dot first name should be the loop element, which is current item from the loop. Not this one, sorry. The collect current item from the loop and first name. Similar way, the single contact dot last name will be current element from the loop dot last name. Similar way, single contact dot email will be the current item dot email dot value. And the important thing is that single contact dot account ID is basically the all accounts data table first selected row and then ID. So that way all the contacts will be created under the selected account. This step is very important. The account ID, contact account ID should match with the selected accounts ID, which I selected inside the data table. Okay. Then we need to handle the checkbox thing, like what will happen when someone wants to share the date of birth. We need to capture that, right? So for that, let's start with a decision element that whether the checkbox is checked or not. That's something that I need to check. So let's put a label as check for date of birth, give the outcome as yes. And here it will be the current item from this one. And then want to share, this one is a checkbox equals to true. If the checkbox is true, that's the time when I want to store the date of birth for the contact. So under yes, I will create one more assignment. Update single contact record. And here the single contact dot dot birth date equals to current element. Yep, dot date of birth. Perfect. Finally, I want to store the single contact in the list of contacts because there can be multiple contacts I have collected through the repeater. That's the beauty of the repeater. That's why we want to use repeater to collect as many information as you want in a single screen. So here I will put I'll put the label as, it will be another assignment to assign the single contact to list of contacts. Here I'll create another variable, but this time the variable will be of, let's give a name as all contacts. Data type will be record. Object will be contact. But the important factor is like I'll select allow multiple values because this is important. It's going to be a list. Then add and finally the single contact. So I'm going to add every contact to this list of contacts. Perfect. And once the loop is done, all I need to do is basically insert those records into my database. So for that, let's create an element called create record. And let's give it a name. Create all contacts. Perfect. And here it will be from the record variable, but we are going to multiple records and the all contacts. Now let's save the flow.
Nine.
Perfect. And click on save. Let's activate. Okay. So before we run the flow, let's review what we have done. So what I have done is basically first I'm selecting all the accounts, showing all the accounts in the data table, and then using the repeater element to capture first name, last name, email address, date of birth for each contacts. And the date of birth field is basically visible based on the checkbox. Once this is done, I'm going through the loop, and for each of this record, I'm going to create a single contact where the first name will be the first name, last name matches last name, important thing, again, the account ID, which should match with the contact account ID, should match with the selected accounts ID from the data table. That's very important part. In the checkbox, I'm checking whether that contact has agreed to share the date of birth. If that is true, then I'm going to update the single contact record and store the birth date value. Finally, I'm going to assign the single contact to the list of all contacts. And at the very end, I'm going to use the create records to create all those contacts. That's all this flow is doing. Now let's go back to the Salesforce org and let's go to the sales app. Let's open accounts and let's open, for example, Jenny Point. And as you can see, I have only one contact under Jenny Point. So now let's run this flow. As you can see, it's collected all the active accounts from my org. So I select Jenny Point, and then let's put the first contact, James Bond, and James at bond.com. Let's add one more contact. Here, let's give this Shane one. And Shane at one.com. But let's say Shane 1 wants to share his date of birth. So we'll click on checkbox checked. And then the date of birth, let's select 1999 and then 15th of April. And then let's click on next. What it will do, it will create two contacts under Jenny Point, James Bond and Shane 1. But only for Shane 1, there will be a date of birth. James Bond, there will be no date of birth captured. So next. And the all contacts are being created. So let's go back to my Jenny Point account and refresh. As you can see, there's two more contacts, James Bond and Shane 1. So let's open both of them in separate tab. If I go to Shane 1 and go to the details section, as you can see, the date of birth is captured. For James Bond, the date of birth is not captured because James Bond doesn't want to share his date of birth. Perfect. So that's the way how you can use the repeater element, which became actually generally available in Summer 24 release. And with this repeater element, you can collect multiple information for your user and then use that information to create related records. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share with your colleagues, and please subscribe to my channel, because in coming few days, I'll be publishing more contents about new features which came up along with Summer 24 release. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.